Archbishop Edward A. McCarthy High School is dedicated to the formation of tomorrow's leaders through a Roman Catholic experience that provides excellence in atmosphere, academics, the arts, and athletics. Our vision is to be one of the most innovative, influential, and accomplished Roman Catholic schools in the nation.
Good morning. My name is Alexandra McNamee. Please stand for our prayer and pledge of allegiance. Today is December 3rd, Tuesday of the first week of Advent. Today is also the memorial of St. Francis Xavier, priest who lived from 1506 to 1552. After becoming a priest, St. Francis Xavier became a missionary to India, Japan, and died of a fever on his way to China. He is the patron saint of Catholic missions, African missions, the city of Goa, India, China, and missionaries. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres, y bendito es tu fruto de tu vientre. Jesús, Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Please turn to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Have a great day, Mavericks.
Welcome to a brand new Tuesday morning. Today we're on a modified Mass Day C-A schedule, and I'm Gabriel Lopez.
And I'm Josiah Sivedom. Let's get straight into today's announcements. Class of 2023, are you feeling a little bit overwhelmed at the thought of your first ever high school midterms?
I mean, I know I was at that time. In fact, I'm still overwhelmed by midterms.
Well, we don't blame you, but don't worry. Linker has got you freshies covered. This Monday, December 9th, will be Candy and Cram, where you can sign up for one subject that you're most worried about and get 90 minutes of help on that subject, and also a free bag of candy. Sign up is on AMHS Student Canvas, so get your spots before they're gone. Remember, you can't sign up for more than one subject, so pick wisely. For any questions or additional information, email Ms. Curtis or Ms. Chris Weiser, or message your link crew leader.
And this week, International Club will be hosting International Week around campus to enlighten our students about the many cultures we coexist with each day.
The theme of this year's International Week is holidays around the world, with holidays such as Kwanzaa, Hanukkah, Ramadan, and Christmas as the main focus. This means that during the week, students can look forward to seeing decorations around campus and having food based on cultures served during lunch periods. There will also be a photo booth at the entrance of the cafeteria where you can take pictures with your friends using some cultural props the club will provide. And on Friday, there will be a festival in the Student Center with performances on stage from 2:35 p.m. to 3:35 p.m. in the courtyard. So come on down and see some live performances by some clubs and teams.
And Christmas dress down days start tomorrow. Tomorrow you can wear a tacky Christmas sweater and jeans if you bring a $10 donation or toy donation of equivalent value. And Thursday and Friday are free dress down days. Thursday being Christmas accessory day, so bring hats, scarves, headbands, red/green with jeans. And Friday will be a Christmas class clash with jeans. 9th grade will be elves.
10th will be snowmen.
10th grade will be reindeers.
And seniors will be dressed as Santa. Also, Mavs, auditions for the spring musical In the Heights will be held on December 9th in the Black Box from 2:45 to 6:30 p.m. Rehearsals are mandatory and are every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, and many Saturdays, from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. until it opens on March 31st to April 5th. Ask Mrs. Keegan for the musical audition cuts before that date.
Are you ready to rock around the Christmas tree and show your holiday spirit in the month of December?
I know I am.
If so, the Deca Club has just the thing for you. Wednesdays through Fridays in December, the Deca Club will be selling Santa scrunchies and Christmas socks during all lunches, just like the ones we have here on the table in front of us. That's you.
The sale starts this Wednesday during lunches and will feature several varieties of Christmas scrunchies and socks for both men and women. including regular warm, cozy socks. The price will be 1 for 3 or 2 for 5, so bring cash and get ready to look all festive all month long. For more information, please see Ms. Portaladdin or Mrs. Stutzman.
And forget spring cleaning. Now is the time to clean out your closets. Loving Soul Shoe Drive is starting now, and they need your help. They will be collecting shoes until December 11th. All shoes will be donated to the Camillus House.
And lastly, Tech Club welcomes all Mavericks to their first Super Smash Bros. Tournament of the year. The fee for the tournament is $5, but you can come and watch at no cost. And there will be prizes for those who win. The tournament will be on December 9th in the iCatholic at 2:45. Good luck, Mavs!
And now, Mavericks, let's pause and take the time to watch an important safety video for everyone here on campus.
Is it the police?
Reports are just coming in, but we don't have a lot of information.
We did.
There's an active shooter situation in South Florida.
IDs out. How many times I gotta tell you? Put them on. Let's go.
We want you to feel safe in this school. Because of the measures that we're putting in, as you see, the cameras, our access ID system, we're preparing for the worst. But it's always better to prepare for the worst and expect the best.
Hi, I'm Nicole Arango, and I interviewed Ms. Frank to discuss some of the safety features that Archbishop McCarthy has to offer.
The school has access control, both interior and exterior. There's two separate systems, so that if one shuts down, the other one is still working. We're able to turn them off, turn them on. When we go into a code red, everything gets shut down at a push of a button off of an iPad. There have been 14 cameras that have been updated to more high definition.
During a code red, if you're stuck outside a classroom, what should you do or where should you go?
The school has established several safe areas to be in. The bathrooms are the first and foremost if you're inside the building. If you're outside of the building, we don't want you to come back in. And not only that, you won't be able to get back in, but if there's something happening in the school building, we don't want to bring you back into danger. So the chapel, the gym, the restrooms down at the other end of the building are all options, as is going just farther out on the campus. If you happen to be into one of the bathrooms, last year we put in a blue light up at the top. It's a piece of blue plastic, and it flashes, and it's to tell you don't come out because we don't have a sound system, and we don't want to necessarily be announcing if something is going on. There are QR codes in all of these places. There's QR codes in the bathrooms. There's QR codes in the chapel and in the weight room and all those areas down at the other end of the building. You scan them, it comes up, and it just asks you, who are you, where are you, who are you with, and is everybody okay?
Thank you, Nicole Arango, and the team for making that really well-made video. And now, let's take things over to John Metzger with the Mavs Sports Report.
Bruh.
Oh, he's so hot.
Welcome back, Mavs, to another episode of Mavs Sports Zone. I'm John Metzger. Let's dive right in. First up, the Miami Dolphins have finally snagged their third and most likely final win of the season. The Finns fought hard against the Philadelphia Eagles and managed a 37-31 victory over the 2018 Super Bowl champs. Back at McCarthy, the Lady Mavericks soccer team have continued their 10-year tradition of volunteering at LiveNet for Families on the Wednesday before Thanksgiving. The organization is dedicated to provide food and other basic resources to those in need. Our Lady Mavs and their coaches help prepare food, clean dishes, sorted clothing, and more to help give back this Thanksgiving. And to top it off, the Lady Mavericks soccer team defeated Cardinal Gibbons by a score of 4-1, keeping their season's perfect record of 4-0. Keep up the great work, ladies. Our swim team meet finished with a whopping 37 swimmers meeting in the district meet. Both men's and women's teams placed 4th out of 10 teams total. Nathaniel Garrick, Ashley Green, and Sven Walker scored the highest at regionals. Great job, Mavs. And we want to end with a big congratulations to senior Jenna Amaro, a member of the Florida All-Star Volleyball team, who won at the ACA All-Star Classic held at Florida Southern. Go Mavericks! Finally, pancreatic cancer research is a cause close to the hearts of many, including the AMHS varsity women's soccer team. This year, the team has a goal to raise as much money as possible in honor of Mavericks soccer dad, James Prieto. You can help reach that goal by purchasing a Lady Maverick t-shirt, where all proceeds will go to a great cause. So make sure to pick one up. Well, that's all we have for today. See you next time on Mav Sports Zone. I'm John Metzger.
Mavericks on three! Mavericks on three!
1, 2, 3, Mavericks!
And with that, let's talk about Giving Tuesday. Giving Tuesday is a global generosity movement unleashing the power of people and organizations to transform their communities and the world on December 3rd, 2019, and every day. Giving online on time exclusively on the to the Schroeder Memorial Fund. On this Giving Tuesday, we ask you to please donate to the Schroeder Memorial Fund. Your support of the Schroeder Memorial Fund will help students continue their Catholic education at McCarthy if the family is facing financial difficulties due to the loss of a parent or health crisis. And with that, that's it for today's show, Mavs. I'm Josiah Cervedo.
And I'm Gabriel Lopez. Stay frosty, Mavericks.